Hi, in previous lecture I discussed different type of algorithm analysis like worst case analysis, best case analysis and average case analysis. In today lecture I will discuss asymptotic notation. Asymptotic notation primarily used for describing running time of an algorithm. There are two type of asymptotic notation, one is big, another is small. Big also contain three type like big O, big omega and theta. Big O is asymptotic upper bound, big omega is asymptotic lower bound and theta is asymptotically tight bound. Next is small. There are two small asymptotic notation. One is little o, another is little omega. Little o represented by small o, while big O represented by capital O. Next, little omega, it is represented by this symbol. Little o is called as proper upper bound and little omega is called as proper lower bound. I'll discuss these five asymptotic notation one by one. Let's start with theta. For a given function gn, we denote by theta of gn this set of functions. This is definition of theta notation. Theta of gn equals to fn if there exist positive constants c1 and c2 and n0, n0 is the threshold point, such that 0 less than equals to c1 gn less than equals to fn less than equals to c2 gn for all n greater than equals to n0. So fn is in between c1 gn and c2 gn. Fn is greater than equals to c1 gn and less than equals to c2 gn. C1 and c2 are positive constant and n0 is the threshold point. Let's see the diagram for theta notation. Fn function is greater than equals to c1 gn and less than equals to c2 gn. We can say fn is sandwiched between c1 gn and c2 gn. N0 is the threshold point. Before that, it doesn't matter. After that, fn value is greater than equals to c1 gn and less than equals to c2 gn. We can write fn belongs to theta of gn, that indicates fn is a member of theta gn. Or we can write fn equals to theta of gn, that expresses the same maximum time. We use this fn equals to theta of gn. This is also correct. We can use any one. For all n value greater than n0, the function fn is equals to gn within a constant factor. These constant factors are c1 and c2. So fn is equals to gn within c1 and c2. We can say that gn is asymptotically tight bound for fn. Let's see one example. Suppose half n square minus 3n, that we can write as theta of n square. Let's determine c1, c2 and n0. Means half n square minus 3n, that is less than equals to c2 n square and that is greater than equals to c1 n square. And for some n0, n value is greater than equals to n0, it will work. Now we need to find what is value of c1, what is value of c2 and what is value of n0. For which c1 and c2 value half n square minus 3n is sandwiched between c1 n square and c2 n square. c1 n square less than equals to half n square minus 3n less than equals to c2 n square. Now we can divide all the function by n square. N square is common in all the function. So after dividing, we'll get c1 n square divided by n square, we'll get c1. Then half n square divided by n square. N square, n square will be cancelled. So 1 by 2. 3n divided by n square, it will be 3 by n. Then c2 n square divided by n square. N square will be cancelled, we'll get c2. And this function should be positive. This fn should be positive. If we'll take 6 in place of n, then 3 by 6, it will be 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, it will be 0. So 6 cannot be value of n. We need to take greater value than 6. Let's take n equals to 7. When we'll take n equals to 7, half minus 3 by 7. It's not equal to 0. So let's consider n0 equals to 7. As for 6, it is getting 0. So we are taking 1 higher, means we are considering n0 equals to 7. 1 by 2 minus 3 by 7. After simplification, 14. Here we'll write 7. Here we'll write 6. 3 multiplication to 6. Now 7 minus 6, it is 1 by 14. So C1 values would be less than equals to 1 by 14 and C2 values would be greater than equals to 1 by 14. Let's consider C1 equals to 1 by 14 and C2 equals to 1 by 2. C1 should be less than equals to 1 by 14 and that should be less than equals to C2. Let me consider C1 equals to 1 divided by 14, that is less than equals to 1 by 14. We can consider less or equal. You can consider 1 by 15, 1 by 16, that will be less than. Then this should be less than C2. So I am considering 1 by 2 for C2. You can consider 1 by 7, 1 by 5, 1 by 4, any value that is greater than 1 by 14 for C2. Any value that is less than equals to 1 by 14 for C1. You can also consider C2 equals to 1 by 14 as here equal symbol is given. You can consider both C1 and C2 equals to 1 by 14. Now 1 by 14 n square less than equals to 1 by 2 n square minus 3 n less than equals to 1 by 2 n square. This is our C1, this is our C2 and n value should be greater than equals to n0 and we are considering n0 equals to 7. Now for n value greater than equals to 7, this will work. Means this value will be greater than equals to this and less than equals to this. This is all about theoretical part of theta notation. Let's discuss O notation. O notation, it is asymptotic upper bound. Theta notation is asymptotic tight bound. For a given function gn, we denote O of gn. Either you can read big O of g of n or O of g of n. Let's see the diagram for O notation. Fn equals to O of gn if fn value less than equals to cgn. And this will satisfy after n0. n0 is the threshold point. This is the definition for O notation. Big O of g of n equals to fn. There exists a positive constant c and n0 such that 0 less than equals to fn less than equals to cgn for all n value greater than equals to n0. Means this cgn value should be greater than equals to fn. Then we can write fn equals to O of gn. Fn equals to O of gn indicates that Fn is a member of O of gn. Fn equals to theta of gn implies Fn equals to O of gn. Let Fn equals to 2n square, then 2n square we can write as theta of n square and also we can write order of n square. If theta satisfy, then O also satisfy. If you can write theta of n square, then you can also write O of n square. Since theta notation is a stronger notation than O notation, theta notation is more tight. We can say theta of gn is subset of O of gn. Let's see one example, a n square plus b n plus c, that we can write as theta of n square. If you remember, I already discussed order of growth. First will be constant, then will be log n, then will be root n, then linear n, n square, n cube, suppose n power 4, 2 power n, n factorial. So this is the sequence of order of growth of different function. For this function, a n square plus b n plus c, theta of n square. And it can be O of n square, O of n cube, O of n power 4, it can be O of 2 power n, it can be n factorial. So O contain all these functions while theta contain only n square function. So we can say theta of gn is subset of O of gn. As O of g of n contain more function than theta of g of n. It includes this function plus it can be n power 3, n power 4, it can be 2 power n, it can be n factorial, it can be any function larger than or equals to this n square. Let's discuss omega notation. Fn equals to omega of gn if fn value greater than equals to cgn and n value should be greater than equals to n0. Just compare these two functions. Here fn is less than equals to cgn. Here fn is greater than equals to cgn. Here fn function is lower than gn function. Here fn function is higher than gn function. And omega notation provide asymptotic lower bound while O notation provide asymptotic upper bound. For a given function gn, we denote omega of gn and it read as big omega of g of n or simply omega of g of n. Let's see definition of omega notation. Omega of gn equals to fn. There exist positive constant c and n0 such that 0 less than equals to cgn less than equals to fn for all n greater than equals to n0. Now compare with the O. Here you can see fn less than equals to cgn. Here you can see cgn less than equals to fn. Means gn function should be less than equals to fn. In case of O, fn function should be less than equals to gn. Let's see this same example for a n square b n plus c where a greater than 0. It is omega of n square, also omega of n, also omega of 1. Let me write some basic function according to their order of growth. First will be 1, then log n, next root of n, then n square, n cube, then n power 4, then 2 power n factorial. These are the some basic function according to order of growth. Now this function a n square plus b n plus c, it can be theta of n square, this is theta, and it can be O of n square, O of n cube, O of n power 4, it can be O of 2 power n factorial. So O will contain all these function. While omega can be, it can be omega of n square, omega of n, omega of root n, omega of log n, omega of 1. So omega will contain all these function. So previous function are for omega, while this for theta, and these functions are for O. That's why you call theta as asymptotic tight bound while O is asymptotic upper bound and omega is asymptotic lower bound. It can be any function that is less than or equals to that function. I discussed all three big notation, theta, big O and big omega. Let's discuss small notation. There is little o and little omega. So first is O notation or it is called as little o notation. The asymptotic upper bound provide O notation may or may not be asymptotically tight. We already discussed that it may or may not be asymptotically tight. Theta is always asymptotically tight, but O and omega are may or may not asymptotically tight. For function 2n square, we can write order of n square. It is asymptotically tight. But for function 2n, we can write order of n square and it is not asymptotically tight. We use little o notation for asymptotically not tight bound. So we use small o notation to denote a upper bound that is not asymptotically tight. We formally define O of gn and it read as little o of g of n as said. This is the definition for small o of g of n. Fn for any positive constant c greater than 0. There exists a constant n0 greater than 0 such that 0 less than equals to fn less than cgn for all n greater than equals to n0. Now just compare this definition with big O notation. In big O notation, 0 is less than equals to fn and fn is less than equals to cgn. But here it is strictly less than. Just mark this symbol. It is strictly less than. Let's see one example. 2n we can write little o of n square, but 2n square, we cannot write little o of n square, it will be tight. And we use little o notation for not asymptotically tight, means it should be strictly less than. Here 2n square is not strictly less than n square, that's why we cannot use. But for 2n, we can write it is little o of n square. What is difference between big O and little o? Here 0 is less than fn, less than cgn, hold for some constant c greater than 0. And in case of little o, 0 less than equals to fn, less than cgn. Here you just mark here less than symbol, here less than equals to. Means fn can be less than equals to cgn. Equals is the extra, it can be equals to, but here fn is strictly less than cgn. And it holds for all constants c greater than 0. The relation fn equals to little o of gn implies that limit n tends to infinity fn divide gn equals to 0. I already discussed by this function we can compare two function. If we found this equals to 0, means fn has smaller order of growth than gn. Or we can write fn equals to small o or little o of gn. Let's discuss little omega notation. We use omega notation to denote a lower bound that is not asymptotically tight. Little o notation is for upper bound that is not asymptotically tight. And little omega is for lower bound that is not asymptotically tight. Fn belongs to omega of gn if and only if gn equals to order of fn. If n equals to n square and gn equals to n, then we can write n square equals to little omega of n, and we can write n equals to little o of n square. So if fn belongs to little omega of gn, then gn also belongs to little o of fn. This function read as little omega of g of n. Let's see the definition for this. Little omega of g of n equals to fn for any positive constant c greater than 0. There exists a constant n0 greater than 0 such that 0 less than equals to cgn less than fn for all n value greater than n0. Let's see one example. For n square divided by 2, we can write little omega of n, but it is not omega of n square. It should be strictly greater than. Now, what is difference between little omega and big omega? In big omega, here it is less than equals to, while in little omega, it is strictly less than. Big omega is asymptotic lower bound, while little omega is for lower bound that is not asymptotically tight. And here, in case of big omega, it can be less than equals to, but in case of small omega, it is strictly less than. Cgn is strictly less than fn. The relation fn equals to little omega of g of n implies that limit n tends to infinity fn divide gn equals to infinity. I already discussed this function during order of growth. If it is infinity, means fn has larger order of growth than gn, or we can write fn equals to little omega of gn. Big O notation is for less than equals to, small o notation is for strictly less than, then big omega notation is for greater than equal to, while small omega notation is for strictly greater than, and theta notation is for equal. In today's lecture, I discussed definition of all asymptotic notation. In next lecture, I'll discuss some example of asymptotic notation. If this lecture is helpful for you, please like and subscribe. Thank you.